Years ago, my wife and I, we took a cruise, and I'm a cruise guy. I'm gonna be grateful when the cruise lines open up again. But I remember we took this cruise the week after September 11th, and we didn't know if we were gonna even be able to take the cruise. But they said the cruise was still on, they opened up the ships. But when we got there, the cruise was leaving late. So what they did is they sent divers under the ship to make sure there were no bombs. During that time, we didn't know what was going on during September 11th. We thought that the whole country was under a terroristic attack from Afghanistan. So they sent divers under the ship. So we literally was delayed for hours. Well, when the ship left, it left late, so we were going against the high tide. And when you're sailing on a ship, no matter how big the ship is, you're not supposed to go against the tide. So when we were on this ship, the ship was rocking from left to right, from east to west. They said the waves were over 45 feet high. And as we were walking on this ship, you could barely walk. I mean, people were walking like this. The ship was turning. The ship was being tossed. People were throwing up. I got sick. And I was like, baby, I got to go to bed. I called the captain. And I said, I need to talk to the captain. I said, Captain, why did you have us leave this late? Everybody's sick. This is not what I anticipated for a cruise. He said, Mr. Andrews, don't worry. This ship is seaworthy. This ship has seen storms before. This ship has gone through different things before. No matter what this ocean throws at us, you trust that this ship is going to be okay. It's the unsinkable ship. It's not going to fall just because we're going against the tide. I said, didn't the guy in the Titanic say that too? Trust me, Mr. Andrews, this is not going to shake this ship. Just go to sleep. I can give you something to settle your stomach. I can have a doctor see you. But go to sleep, I promise you, in the morning it's going to be okay. And sure enough, we got up that morning and the ship was okay. You know what? Y'all ever heard of the Ark of Safety? The Ark of Safety is talking about this Noah's Ark story, where even though the waves had come in, and even though the flood had came, and even though the storms were death, as long as they were in the Ark of Safety, they were going to be all right. It may toss you a little bit. It may make you sick. It may make you frustrated. But as long as you're in the Ark of Safety, you're going to be all right. Does anybody know who the Ark of Safety is? Does anybody know who the Ark of Safety is? The Ark of Safety is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. The Ark of Safety is that man named Jesus who was able to take on your sin, take on my sin. That one that was able to die and take on death, snatch the keys of death, and raise with all power in his hand. No matter what life throws at you, I know it may toss you. I know you may get weary. I know you might get sick. But stay in the Ark of Safety, and I promise you, you're going to get to your destination. The charge for us is to simply be faithful. The charge for us is to be faithful. And I promise you, if you're faithful over a few things, God will entrust you with many more things. Noah preached for 120 years, but he proved to be faithful. Noah followed every detail, but he proved to be faithful. Nobody listened to Noah, but he proved to be faithful. Will God find you?